Last night, water, fortnight, moonshine, no fish.
Today, I have an English listening challenge for you. I'm going to show you some clips of a variety of different accents that can be found in the United States. With each clip, I'm going to show you with subtitles, but I'm going to omit a couple of words. And your job is, number one, fill in the blank with the correct word. And then number two, guess which part of the US this accent comes from. One thing to mention before starting, not all accents from the same region or even the same city sound the same. Accents can be as unique as people and are influenced by many different factors, such as your socioeconomic background, age, ethnicity, race, as well as a person's individual history.
So it's nice for the children to know. Because all they know now is put things in the microwave, put them in and take them out, bang, you know. Then they wonder why they got so one thing wrong with their body.
The first clip is from Charleston, South Carolina. This woman is a speaker of the Gullah language, which is an English-based Creole. So her accent is heavily influenced by Gullah. The first phrase is, because all they know now is to put things in the microwave. Let's watch it again.
So it's nice for the children to know. Because all they know now is put things in the microwave, put them in and take them out, bang, you know. Then they wonder why they got so one thing wrong with their body.
The hard part is shoveling the roof off all the time, you know. Last year I fell off of it, but you know, with the snow there, it's a cushion, you know, and you fall in it and it buries you, and you just lay there and laugh, you know.
This next speaker is from Michigan. This is called the Upper Peninsula accent. The first missing word is, the hard part is shoveling the roof.
The hard part is shoveling the roof off.
The second is, you know, with the snow there, it's a cushion. It's a cushion.
You know, with the snow there, it's a cushion, you know, and you fall in it and it buries you, and you just lay there and laugh, you know.
You're probably, I've never been on live television before, but apparently sometimes I don't watch the news because I'm a kid, and apparently Grandpa just gives me a remote after he watched the Powerball.
This next clip is also from Michigan. I chose this one because children have different ways of speaking, so I wanted to give another example of kid speech, which can be a little bit more challenging. The first word that's missing is apparently. He says, apparently, I've never been on live television before.
Apparently, I've never been on live television before.
On the internet, this kid is known as the apparently kid because he says apparently a lot.
Apparently.
The next missing word is remote. And it says, and apparently Grandpa just gives me the remote after he watches the Powerball.
Apparently Grandpa just gives me a remote after he watched the Powerball.
Where is the closest Starbucks?
I found 17 places matching Starbucks.
Can I park my car in Harvard Yard?
This next clip is from Boston, Massachusetts. He said, can I park my car in Harvard Yard. The Boston accent is very well known for dropping the R's in many words. Let's listen to it again.
Where is the closest Starbucks?
I found 17 places matching Starbucks.
Can I park my car in Harvard Yard?
Where I'm from, there's nothing there. All we had to do was ride dirt roads and we'd go to pastures, and then I had to look off to the car. And one time my dad got so mad because I did donuts in the pasture. My aunt took a car and it caught on fire.
This clip is from my home state of Alabama. The first missing word is pastures. It says we'd go to the pastures.
All we had to do was ride dirt roads and we'd go to pastures.
The next missing word is fire. And it caught on fire.
Because I did donuts in the pasture. My aunt took a car and it caught on fire.
I run into people I don't know, never seen them in my life, and I help any way I can. Somebody said one day, did you get knocked in the head? I said, well, if I do, I'm just knocked. I guess good hearted.
This next accent is from the Appalachian region of the U.S., specifically in North Carolina. The first missing word is life. He says, I've never seen them in my life.
I run into people I don't know, never seen them in my life.
The next missing word is good-hearted. We're just good-hearted.
I guess good-hearted.
You've been shrimping all night. You're tired, you're wet, you're hungry. You've just been shredded to pieces all night. You have their mom.
Our final accent is from Ocracoke, North Carolina. This is an Outer Banks accent. So there is a line of islands off the coast of North Carolina. Historically, the people who first settled there from Ireland, Scotland, England, they were pretty isolated. They were fishermen, they lived off the sea. So their accent evolved in a different way than many other North American accents. So this one, the first one says, you've been shrimping all night. So shrimping means fishing for shrimp.
You've been shrimping all night. You're tired, you're wet.
The next word says, you have been mommicked.
You've just been shredded to pieces all night. You have been mommed.
This one was kind of unfair because this word doesn't exist in other parts of the U.S. Let's listen to the explanation of this word again. So this is a word that is very particular to the Outer Banks, to Ocracoke.
It's just about as bad as it can get. To be mama is just about as bad as it can get. It means to shred or tear apart, to just, no other word for it except mama.
All right, those are all of our accents today. Let me know in the comments which one you found to be the most challenging to understand. Have you also ever heard any other difficult to understand English accents? Let me know. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.